Hi guys and welcome to Usitility. Today we are on the way to see how to play Bullet Force on PC. From now you can display it on your screen. We will be able to effortlessly download and set up Bullet Force so that we can play the game on the Windows PC using our keyboard, mouse and big screen. Then it's time to have fun, let's get to it. Before anything else my friends, to get started we have to launch our favorite browser. We selected the one we use by default. Let's continue, going to the current URL that I'm highlighting in green color. Now, you can see on the screen of the PC. There is no need to type anything, simply because I added the link in the video description and as well in the first main comment. We landed below on our Usitility internet site, where we have a detailed description on just how to download Bullet Force on PC. We scroll down a little bit and also click on the Download Game on PC button. Once clicking on that link, we land here on the website of LDPlayer. No panic, it is simply the Android emulator that we will run to get access to that game Bullet Force on our PC. As you can discover from here we get several advantages of running that emulator, custom controls, multiple instances, instance synchronization, macros, scripts, high FPS, and the list goes on. So we are on the way to proceed to download the Bullet Force by clicking on this button Download Bullet Force on PC that you can visualize here in green. Next step is clicking on that button. Of course, the download starts and ends immediately. Here it is, here is located the download. It's a file to execute. What we have to do now is to launch the installer, okay, then we need to click on the file. Windows 10 users will be asked for permission to allow changes to the device. We have clicked yes. I minimize the web browser to see the installer better. The installation software is uncomplicated. It consists of two possibilities, install, and setup path. I am going to clarify what setup path does indeed. We only simply click on it. And so we discover that we have here the path where the emulator can be set up. If we desire to modify this folder we have got to click on this browse option, so we select another directory and set up the emulator precisely where we prefer. I am going to set it by default. Then, I click on back. And therefore I pick install. At this moment, before you start the installation of the emulator, will also be possible that it will show us more than one application packages to add on the desktop. As I do not need any of those software programs, I purely click each time on the reject button. Great. The install starts and it will go forward together with the download of these megabytes which are represented on this computer screen. The moment you save it on your hard disk, it could possibly be slightly more or less MB. The download rate may go at a higher speed or slower, determined by your internet and depending on the efficiency of the emulator web servers. Now they are running extremely fast. The download is finished, so now it proceeds with the setup step. The installation will need a little bit more or less time based on the strength of your computer or laptop, the more efficient it really is, the shorter the software setup time and or vice versa. If we put together the download and installation stage it can take a considerably long time, so be patient. It has now ended for me. At this time, the emulator has actually been launched automatically. As you can see now, at the bottom of the screen, there is a progress bar that will move forward to the right so when it gets to the finish, the emulator can be started for the very first time. Believe it or not the emulator is already launched, here it is for the very first time. And therefore LD Store is by default launched, which is a sort of Google Play. This is simply not the most correct approach to set up the video game, therefore I tend not to endorse it, due to the fact typically the LD Store puts an out-of-date version of the Android game. I will explain you how to set up the game by using the Google Play, therefore I recommend you to do it this way. First of all, we will have to do is to go to the computer's desktop by hitting this icon that I am indicating in green color. Before we continue on, as you understand, it has created two app icons here on the PC desktop. The LD Player and LD Multiplayer. Note that the LD Player software icon is definitely the only one we're focused on. At any time when we are planning to operate Bullet Force on the laptop or computer, we twice click on that icon and therefore launch the emulator. The LD Multiplayer app icon has nothing to do with multiplayer or even anything like that, the fact is that, it's an software icon that we might very likely never ever make use of. Let me make the next step, which is a must-have, and that's to entry the Google Play Store. To achieve this we will browse here to, System Apps, we click. And we are going to mouse-click on Play Store. As can be seen the Google Play is presented. Here we have to log on. Currently the moment we are here, we must absolutely accomplish the following step that is imperative. So that we just click on, Sign In. At present it announces, Checking Info. It can sometimes get stopped at Checking Info, and this does not progress. In that case, you should try to log in after a number of hours and it'll almost certainly be resolved. At present we shall enter our email and password. The email has to be a Gmail email address as well as its matching password. For instance you could use the same exact email you use at this moment in your own YouTube account. So that I am going to submit my data and I'll come back when I have accomplished it. Voila, information entered. Here is Google welcoming us and presenting us the terms of service. We can approve them all by simply pressing, I agree. Then, it allows us to back up to the Google Cloud. You can keep it checked and it will build a backup of your files on that device to Google Drive. I won't select it, you do what you want. We click on accept. By now Google Play is presented as favorite choice and automatically. In case that the Google Play isn't launched immediately and you have no idea how to start it yourself, I reveal to you how to do so. The very first thing is to head to the emulator desktop by simply clicking on this software icon designated in green. Presently we navigate to the System Apps folder. And we select the Play Store icon. Great, I am here inside Google Play. What we intend to do now is go here to search for apps and games. And consequently we're going to search for Bullet Force. There we have got it, we are going to click the very first result. On this page we access to the game. So let's then click there on the Install button that I am showing now in green color. This action will initiate the installation. Now it is going to download on your PC and install the video game. It could take quite some time or perhaps it may just be amazingly quickly. This all is going to depend on our own connection to the web. It's already ended installing. It's time to go back to the emulator desktop by simply clicking on this button I'm presenting in green, in order to run Bullet Force for the first time. I am at present on the emulator desktop, and we're on the way to just click on this brand new Bullet Force app icon that was generated. That Android game is launched for the first time. Here we have it, I can press anywhere on the screen and also make use of the keyboard. I am going to talk about the volume of the emulator. This is here. We have the icon of higher volume and also the icon of lower volume. This manner we do not count on the Microsoft Windows volume to increase or decrease the sound experience of the emulator. And also to appreciate the experience to the fullest, we can activate the big screen, for which we have two choices. This one is simply the first one, we mouse click on that icon that I'm identifying in green color. Thus the display screen is maximized, having one border on top, one at the right and one at the bottom. If ever we aspire to enjoy the game using all the screen, we select this game icon. And we'd already be enjoying the gameplay in full screen mode. To get out of the 100% screen functionality, hit the F11 key. And we might already be in standard computer screen mode. At this point, I am ready to show you the keyboard mapping and that is actually very enjoyable. That strategy we will likely be in a position to operate the video game much more effortlessly. The first point is to click on this software icon. It's now time to make the necessary setups. I am about to leave the standard settings, though if you need to adjust this, you can also do it now without having problem. I use this moment to comment that sometimes, when launching the video game a black screen shows up, if it is so and you experience the black display and that emulator doesn't commence, I suggest a plausible fix. We can hop on over, to the cogwheel. Inside the emulator preferences, in the advanced option we have a large number of image resolutions. This is the pixel quality we have now specified as favorite choice and so we should select any of these other resolutions, for instance that one below. We go for it and then click save. It will probably ask us to restart this emulator and right after rebooted, probably the emulator will launch and your black screen will cease to exist. Perhaps you have realized, the emulator is absolutely in our language. Sometimes it occurs that the emulator is launched in the incorrect language, for instance, in Japanese. And so to set it up in the right language we click here to the cogwheel. So right here within other configuration settings, we simply click on the language drop down. We could pick the language we prefer, Italian, Japanese, and so on. As soon as the language is selected, we should save, the emulator will reboot, and also the game, next time we launch it, will also be in the opted for language. Right now, you will find another detail that we must take into consideration, and it is that we will receive an email telling that a completely new equipment has been associated with this Google account. It should question us if we're the individuals who have associated with that device. Yup, we should not be troubled, because the emulator is simulating an Google Android smartphone or tablet. And in order to identify which device is being emulated, we visit here, to the cogwheel and we just click on it. Be sure you browse here to the Model option. And here we learn that the emulator is acting as a Samsung cell phone. And so we're going to receive an email saying that a new Samsung device has been connected to our Google account. This is it guys, so much for the tutorial. I hope that you liked it, especially that you thought it was informative. In this case, allow it a superb like, subscribe to our channel, and if you have feedback, issues or suggestions, put them in the comment box down below. You may also leave a remark on my Twitch channel, I conduct live streams on occasion, you have it below in the video description and in the very first pinned comment. Just click on any of these videos which are usually appearing on the computer screen and see you in the future video game videos. Bye.